We were able to sort of say, can we solve this very particular problem, which is, can we understand what people are saying to the answer to a particular question? And we've got to a level now that not only we can outperform a human market researcher in that area, but because we're so good, we're able to say to clients, you don't need to ask 60 survey questions, you can ask one or two open questions and learn from that. It's not good enough for identifying who are the unhappy people in your organization. It's good enough maybe for looking at a large organization and looking at overall trends, but I still question you in most employee surveys, you can ask a better question by using a closed question. Where what's important though is to sort of look at the question and say, what are people talking about? And if I think about that chief executive looking at every single comment, what our goal is to say, here's one side. Let's summarize that, not just and say they're talking about leadership or management, but what are they talking about leadership and management? And which are the 20 statements that you really have to read because they're complete outliers and we think they hold the most value? I think it's vital for HR that they get involved in people analytics. I think it's very important that those conversations go to the business, that they partner very well with the business. And it always excites me to solve business problems. You know, even when we're doing employee voice, it's not so much about engagement type questions, but you know, when a business turns around and says to 30,000 people in the stores, what can we do to improve customer experience in stores? And we're able to summarize that and turn those answers around in 10 days from their original question. That's provided using HR and the employee data to make real business impact. And that might have taken a management consultancy 3 months to do. My biggest worry is the ability to get business interpreters who in HR who have good enough understanding of the business and can then look at the workforce implications of that. And within HR, we've struggled at this for 10, 15, 20 years of having people who really understand the business and can talk business rather than HR. And this applies to analytics just as much as it applies to being a generalist.